Guys. Oh God. We got a fucking tornado over here. A serious tornado. I'm not even joking. Going, guys, Dragast here, and welcome back to another episode of Universe Sim. So, we are finally back in this game. The save state has been implemented into the game, so we are building our first real civilization in this game. In the first episode, it was pretty rough. You know, we had famine, we had storms, like there was a global snowstorm. So if you missed that episode, I do recommend you go check it out. But yeah, we're gonna leave off exactly where we left off and continue building this little empire here. Now, I did notice, you can see the new hairdos. Because we put down that hair salon, all my nuggets now have these awesome hairstyles as well, and they just look, well, at least most of them do, whoever actually visits it, but they look fantastic, especially with their getup. So, yeah, we're gonna do the same thing today, and let's actually check, do we have anything queued up right now? No, we do not, so we're gonna wanna start up there. All right, so now we're getting into upgrading. So before you used to be able to just upgrade, I believe, automatically, or it was already upgraded when you got it. Now you actually do unlock upgrading. So we can either upgrade the eatery as well as additional worker slot and pyre. That's oh yeah, I guess ovening. Okay, you're burning bodies, you're cooking food in the same place. That's absolutely great. I don't really need that. Well upgrade would be really nice though, so I think we're gonna do that one. What's this last one? Hospital upgrade. Again, that would be nice, but I think the water is going to be our biggest issue. So we're gonna put that up, and then we will also put 5% faster medicine prep. All right, and next up, what else do we want to do? I'm thinking, let's do another local business, because I want to see if these are random. The first one was the hair salon, or saloon. The next one, what's going on over here? It's so smoky. What did you guys do? What? Oh, this is a little house. Okay. Didn't realize my huts are going that far down, but yeah, I'm just gonna put this, we'll just rotate this a little bit that way, and just see. I mean, if we have two hair salons, I can just demolish one. I'm just curious. I think it randomly puts down businesses. So the more we have, the better, because happiness is a really difficult thing now, and that's pretty much the only way how you gain it. Now, storage is looking pretty good. We actually have food for once. Also, farming has, well, they were farming. I guess it's not happening right now. No farmer present. Okay, he's recovering in the hospital. So, yeah, we're not doing farming just yet. So, it is autumn right now. We're going to put down some of these other structures that we haven't just yet. Definitely going to do the bunker right now because we've seen the storms that can happen on this planet now. That is beautiful. I love how the little fire's going. But, yeah, obviously, we're going to want a bunker. So, I'm just going to put this kind of by the rocks over here if I can. Keep it out of the way, but close enough so people can run into it. All right, clearly it doesn't want to be by this rock at all, so we'll just put it out over here, I guess. So that's the bunker. We also have, whoops, that's not the button I wanted to press. In production, we have the wood refinery and the stone refinery. These are new things, I believe. Nuggets have taken to chopping trees down around the epicenter. That's all good and well, but what are they going to do with all that wood? Just leave it lying around? No. You can't have that. A wood refinery will allow them to shape it into more useful materials so we can make timber. Now, I don't know if that's going to unlock a new form of housing. I honestly have no idea, but we're going to put these down right now anyways because we're going to need them. And look at the baby lovemaking going on over here. Double. All right, you guys are doing good. What do we got? Okay, there's a, ooh, that's a thunderstorm over there. Okay, we don't want to go down over there. I'm thinking about wrapping around this lake, though, because we got this little guy here, and we got another big lake over here. I want to keep to all the lakes, so I'm feeling like this kind of middle area is a really good spot as we are expanding out now. We need more and more room, so I think we're going to start building a little bit over here, especially considering there's huts over here, so clearly my good old nuggets want it to happen over here. So we're gonna put both of these down. That might be a little bit risky just because these guys are not the most efficient of people, but I feel like this is going to be a long process. So we'll just keep these here. Actually, let me see how much it costs. Oh, it's not that bad. 35 wood, 35 stone each, which is better than most of these houses. The massage is able to stand up on its own now. So yes, just as I expected. So we got, I love that. I didn't even notice there's a comb on the top to advertise the building, but now we have a massage parlor. Where did I put it? Is it this? Yeah, there we go. Few things in the world are as soothing as a good massage. Nuggets tend to tense up pretty regularly. It probably has something to do with the long work hours and endless environmental hazards. A finger in the right place can work one... Whoa, okay, getting a little too far there. I mean, you know what happens at certain massage parlors, and talking about fingers going places? Yeah, that could get pretty interesting. So, we don't have to hire anyone for this? It looks like it's just literally empty, so... Yeah, I guess I'll just wait for someone to get a nice massage as well. With special fingers somewhere, I guess. That is, it's just so weird. So that's weird to me. I mean, what are you gonna do, massage yourself? So our well upgrade should be happening soon. I just wanna check some stuff, making sure everything's okay. We've actually used, is that right? That does not seem right at all. We've used 35% of the water over here, total amount of water that a water source can contain. Well, crap, I didn't feel like I was using that much water. How much have I used? Okay, so we got lots more water over here. We still got 98% of that pool. So yeah, it makes sense, obviously. That is a really small pool. Maybe I should even get rid of the well so we can... Well, no, you know what? We'll just make it go bone dry and actually get rid of it. That might be really cool to see if it's possible to do that. We also got this water over here. I mean, we got lots of water around us, so we're okay. And the winter has begun. Hopefully, we should be okay for food. I didn't really focus on it too much. We got a few cooked meals. Mind you, it says we have 21 food down below. So, winters aren't too bad in this game as compared to some other games. So, I think we should be okay. Let's just hope a storm doesn't hit before we make our bunker, which I believe is this, yeah, right here. Which looks like it's going to be done. Well, no, actually, it still takes a lot of resources. Why is the water... What is going on here? The water is all... Look at this. Is this... Okay, is this just some lighting effect or something? Because this is really... I think it's just actually the ice thawing. Yeah, that looks like that's what it is. So it does slowly, realistically thaw, which is cool as well. All right, so... Oh my god, what are you? Are you just a little... It's Elu! Elu, you are small and adorable. I can hardly see you. Whatever you're holding is like taking up your whole body. All right, so we got some more stuff to unlock. Let's figure out food preservation, which gives eatery food capacity by 5%. Well, I honestly don't think I can even fill that. Nugget water needs negative 10. Yeah, we are definitely going to research that because we're having water issues, as you can see right now. Might need to put down another well. What else do we got? Ovening. You know what? The eatery only has 2 sitting spots, so I think an eatery upgrade would be really useful right now. The hospital, a farm upgrade, additional worker slot, and plus 1 crop plot. All right, that will be a very good one as well, obviously, but let's do ovening for right now because I want to make sure everybody's happy in the eatery. The bunker is able to stand, so let's go check out what this thing looks like. Yeah, it looks legit like a bunker, so we got a nice sloped... side here to deal with the wind, and I'm assuming it goes underground, so that is really cool. And that's how many nuggets it holds. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 12, 16. So 20 nuggets total. That's going to be most of our population, so that should be good for right now. We'll obviously do another one once we hit around 40. All right, so let's address our Halho has departed this world due to old age. They will be momentarily missed. All right, so my gravedigger should deal with that for me. We don't need to worry about that. Old age is a good thing. If they're dying by old age, that's the ultimate goal. All right, but we're gonna address the water issue right now because we're using more water than we are obtaining. So I think what we should do is put another well down because the well only holds so much. So let's see, is there any better areas? We're moving over here kinda. So if we, oh, it's even worse over here. Hence, I mean, that kinda makes sense because there's a desert over here. So 25 seems to be our best bet, unfortunately. 23 over here, 0. Ugh. So yeah, I just wanted to bring a well a little bit closer to a civilization as well because we got this over here, but we are kind of expanding down this way. So I think we'll put one down over here, and that's going to allow us to store double the water. That's going to probably make drinking a hell of a lot easier. And we're also going to put down another water pump on this lake over here, hopefully. Now, can we not do it? Okay, we can do it during winter. Perfect. So we'll take that there. And that's perfect because we are slowly moving down here as well. All right. Look at this snowfall. Look at how beautiful this is. I think we're in... I can hear a little bit of wind. Let's actually zoom out. Yeah, we're in a little bit of a storm here. Nothing like last episode, though, and I love how there's different varying degrees of storms now. This is just a nice light snowfall. It's a nice winter day for the good old Nuggets here. Looks like some of our Nuggets are becoming older. We don't have too many kids right now, so we need to make some babies, but we are rapidly expanding now. We started this episode with like 14, I believe, and we're already at 25, so doing pretty good there. A little worried about the food situation. I think winter's almost over, though. Is this... Oh, that's the old age guy! Where the hell... Oh, we're gonna have to deal with a bad gravedigger again, aren't we? So, yeah, I don't want to spread disease, so... Oh, what the hell was that noise? Let's just bring him right into the graveyard here, and let's make sure going for amusement. Ooh-hoo, you are still the worst freaking gravedigger, but I'm hoping you're going to the massage. Nope, she's going to get a haircut. I wanted to see what the massage parlor does. All right, let's see what's wrong with Ooh-hoo. Is she sad? Might is rather low, so maybe as a gravedigger, that's not the best idea. And her carrying's really low, so... Maybe, you know what, I think we should fire Ooh-hoo, just because she hasn't been doing a very good job, and I don't think she's really the nugget for this job. So we're gonna go over here. Yes, the infection did just spread, so it's a good thing we brought him over here. And you're fired, Ooh-hoo. I'm sorry, but let's get someone who's a little happier, a little stronger. All right, let's sort it by happiness, because a good nugget is a happy nugget. And look at that. Some of our laborers are the happiest people, so... Kimbu, I am going to... Kalimbu, rather. I'm going to give you the job of gravedigger. Hopefully you can do a little bit better. Looks like we're doing some clear cutting over here. We really are. I mean, that's the one issue with this place. The timber and rock is really, really sparse. We do got a nice forest over here, though. So I think we're going to go down both coastlines as we do expand here. All right, so we got that upgrade, but I'm not getting any more eating spots in the eatery. So I'm not really sure. Is there an upgrade menu now? I honestly have no idea, but we got other problems as well. Certain residential buildings, it looks like the timber mill, have no water. So water is becoming a huge issue. I still got this thing queued up over here. I'm trying to get them to prioritize it, but again, prioritize doesn't seem to really work in this game, unfortunately. So yeah, once again, it's kind of a rough time right now. We're hungry. At least happiness is rather good this time. But yeah, we definitely do gotta get some food in the table. Where is my fisherman? Doing nothing? No, you need to fish! Alright, so because we need more food, let's research the crop plot. What was it called? Fertilization. That's going to allow us to upgrade our fields, hopefully. Which is something we desperately need to do. Moving to the farm, so this is the start of the year. We are going to be making some man-bro fruit, which is good. So we should be okay as long as nobody dies in the near future, because food should be coming in now. All right, Operation We Need More Water is in full works right now, so I'm going to be putting another one down over here. I got one over here. I'm trying to tell them to go do it, but maybe it's too far away. Like, I have no idea. But everything else is pretty much built, and nobody is still going over there. So hopefully having it over here should make them a little bit happier. Let's prioritize that and address this. And again, we are losing a lot of our population due to old age, so death is going to be a common occurrence now. We got nuggets of different ages throughout, you know, young through old. So I think I'm going to have to build a pyre as well because, well, this is our hospital. Let's actually, where is our... Oh no, it's right over here. I am clearly blind. So how many spots do we have left? Yeah, we only got 3 spots left. So at that point, yeah, we need something else to deal with bodies. Cemeteries are great, but funeral pyres are even better. So yeah, last time we got this, I didn't really know how it works. So hopefully this time we can kind of figure it out. We're just gonna keep this. Yeah, you know what? We'll just put it right by the cemetery. I mean, that's a good spot for it. And I'm not even gonna prioritize that because I need water first. First and foremost. Well, the good thing is food's coming in now, as you can see. We're harvesting our man-bro fruit. Again, though, like, nobody's even put anything here. Is it because we don't have timber, maybe? No, look at all this storage. We got 79 stone, for God's sakes, and enough wood. So yeah, a little frustrating. Oh, it looks like we got a broken massage parlor. I wonder who did that. I'm gonna go fix this. Yeah, we're having lots of broken issues now. All right, we'll do that. There we go. Fix that thing up for you. Wow, we got lots of broken stuff. How's the engineering going? Do we need another engineering hut? It says manageable. I'm assuming difficult, but manageable. Guys! Oh god. We got a fucking tornado over here. A serious tornado, I'm not even joking. Alright, it looks like it's gonna miss us. Thank god! But oh my god, the weather in this game is amazing! Alright, well, looks like- Is it coming back now? It is definitely kind of random. It seems to go- well, it is going that way right now. Oh, that is so scary, though. Oh, thank god we have that bunker already. Just realize we also have a restaurant here. A growing civilization means that you'll soon need more chairs at the dinner table, with the community beginning- what the fuck was that? Okay, that was an autosave. But, yeah, you know what? I'm gonna put that down. We can maybe put it right by the other eatery. We'll still keep the old eatery for right now, but it's nice to see that there's new upgraded units. So I guess, yeah, we gotta kind of put it over here. This is probably gonna be really expensive. We're still waiting on everything, like the wells not being built. I don't know, like, are my fucking laborers on strike? Like, I really don't understand. Let's go see, let's just look around and see. Going to construction, going to chop tree. Which construction are you guys doing right now? Is it the funeral pyre? Why are you guys doing this? I didn't even tell you to do this! Yet you're over here, and you're basically done building it. So I guess I can't complain, but yeah, when I tell you to do something else, it'd be great if you actually went over and did it. And I don't know what happened to our hospital here, but it's not looking too good. Mind you, people are still able to use it when it's broken. So there we go, we fixed it though. Everything's good. This is being built. This guy's got a broken leg and he's still working. That's commitment. And yeah, it's going okay right now. I'm just, the water issue, it's very frustrating. Because I could easily do this if I could just tell them, you know, just come here and throw shit on it, please. We had two deaths here. One was caught by infection by drinking the lake water. That's not good. Well, I'm hoping my gravedigger will deal with it. Mind you, the funeral pyre is ready to go. I'm still waiting for timber to be put into it. Oh, God. We got another thunderstorm coming in. How much space? Okay, so we got two more spots in here. That cemetery is officially filled once those guys go into the ground. So we got to get that thing set up quickly. I'm having a really hard time here, guys, to be honest. It is just everything is going wrong at the same time. And there's not enough engineers, as you can see. They still haven't built the damn wells, and I'm sick of complaining about it, but it gets frustrating after I've been playing for, well, 30 minutes now, and the wells still haven't been built. So, like, I don't know what to do at this point. And these things, I mean, look at, they break so quickly. I only do a little bit of repairing with this god tool, unfortunately. I really wish it was a full repair. Because, yeah, these engineers are nowhere to be found. Ah! God damn. So I think I found my problem. Now, if we go to any stone hut that's being built, the amount of supporters is absolutely crazy. So I think my population is expanding so much that their first priority is to obviously get shelter. Now, anything else that pops up, there's no support for them. So I can't totally control them. They have to support what they want, but it's all the time, it's stone houses. So we are building stone houses everywhere. I can't stop them from doing that. They put them down, they build them themselves. And as you can see, like, the amount of support they get is ridiculous. So obviously those are gonna be built first because my civilization seems to think stone huts are more important than water. So my only assumption is we're just gonna have to wait till people die to the point where we don't need any more houses and then maybe we'll be okay with water. We're in another winter already. I mean, that was a whole year of not building one damn well. So, yeah, the water issue is real. Now, we do got some dead people here. I don't know how that guy's hanging out in the wheelbarrow. Oh, God. Oh, no, no. I wanted to see if the funeral pyre would work, but instead, we got another. This is, like, the worst time right now. We got no water at all anywhere. Oh, this is bad. This is bad. All right, repair. I have at least figured out that I can stack my godly duties to the point where we can actually fully repair these things. So that's good, but we need them to get to the shelter here. Or do I have to, like, how do I tell them to go in? I'm assuming they're gonna go there when they want to. And we just lost someone due to hunger. Now, we survived that storm, but it is getting very, very difficult to address all these issues going on. We have no more things we can research either, so it is not going perfectly right now. Pretty much all my population is hungry as hell. They don't want to build wells. I believe I put up another fishing pier somewhere. Maybe I didn't. Okay, so we definitely do want to do some more fishing. We want to do some more farming, but I'm trying to not give them things to build to hope that when they're done with their houses, they'll build the well and the pump. So I'm kind of at a standstill right now. I really, really want to put down some more farms and some more fisheries so we can get some more food, but I feel like killing off some people might be the thing that I need to do. So they have a hut over here, and I noticed that there wasn't anybody that was interested in building it. Yeah, they have no supporters at all. So maybe, just maybe, they'll finally snap out of it and build the well. And another one dead due to hunger. So I feel like the funeral pyre is going to get good work going for it right now. Because people are starting to get very, very hungry. It's still winter time right now, so we can't even really fish very well. And looking at the statuses, because I was curious what the hell all my laborers are doing. Nothing. Doing nothing, doing nothing, going to rest, amusing, doing nothing, going for amusement. Some of them were suicidal before. I mean, it is just, okay, fixing a building. So some of them do some stuff, but it's just like, what? What is going on? Why won't you build the damn pump? All right, I've sped up time. At this point, I have given up trying to, you know, make everything perfect. I decided to go into damage control mode and actually intentionally kill off anyone that's starving or anything, because we need to keep the civilization safe. And unfortunately, because they don't want to build wells, the only way I can do that is by killing people. So yeah, quite a few have unfortunately died. We're down to 24 residents now. I'm just looking around for the bodies so disease doesn't spread as we do slowly burn these. So yeah, it kind of sucks. It's kind of sad, but it's accurate as well. You know, famine happens, chaos happens, and sometimes death is needed. So we're gonna bring these guys over here. I mean, there is a lot. There's two people right here. I think this is contaminated over here because people are drinking the water and dying. We got 5 bodies right here alone. Well, one benefit is it is now summertime, so we don't have to deal with, oh my God. Let's just drop them all there. There might be some disease spreading, but obviously, it's summertime, so we are going to be earning some more food again. I would have loved to put down a fishing pier, but again, we are waiting for wells. Just to try to see if maybe that placement wasn't good. I put another well over here, too. But yeah, it is not fixing it. So I have tried all 3 lakes, different spots on all the lakes, and still, we're having well issues. Is this guy dead or alive? Is he almost dead? He's laying on the ground, yet he's moving. So I don't know if I should consider him dead or not, but we are having troubles with infection as well now, though. So obviously, we have way too many dead bodies around. There's another dead one. we're down to 18. So I might be crazy, but oh God, we got another dead guy here. It's looking like, yeah, is my game broken? What the hell is this? Look at, we got this guy paddling. He's not going anywhere. If you look, nobody is moving right now. Lots of people are crying. So I think what happened was my game glitched out, because it shouldn't be that hard to build a well. So that is quite a big bummer here. I'm still gonna play. I'm gonna go for it here and just see what happens. I did, for the record, try and load up the save multiple times. Didn't work. So yeah, unfortunately, reloading isn't fixing it either. So this honestly really bums me out, because I was really enjoying this game. But obviously, if we're having some bugginess issues here, I don't want to play it just yet, because this game's amazing, but there's obviously a lot of issues. Oh God, the tornado's coming back. It keeps poking its head out, but it never actually comes over here. I think I might be regretting saying that, but... Oh, God. My whole game's broke anyways, Tornado, so feel free. Oh god, it's breaking stuff. Why? Isn't this enough already that I got a damn broken game? Look at that. That is so cool, though. It's popping out things. That went right through my whole thing. And the game crashed as well. Oh my god. All right, guys. Well, obviously, we're going to end this one here. That was a pretty big bummer this episode. I'm going to be honest. I mean, I had a fun time playing, but this whole time I was troubleshooting an issue, and I think it was just a glitch. Now, the good thing is I actually do have a load that was before the big tornado. We got 34 population, so just about when we started dying due to starvation. So what I'm gonna do is, first of all, you know, talk to the developers, see if maybe I'm doing something wrong. I don't think I am, though, and if it is a glitch, we can obviously wait it out, see if there's a fix, and, you know, continue from there. So we're not gonna have to deal with that tornado. We're not gonna have to deal with that crazy famine, but still a little bit of a bummer that the game was that glitchy. But yeah, not every episode can go exactly as I want it to. So yeah, we're gonna wrap it up here, guys. As always, thanks for watching and liking, and I'll see you in the next one.